Now, let us look at a little bit more complicated situation. Okay, we will stick on, we are still on this condition that we have the uniform electric field or constant electric field. Okay, like this. We have the electric field like this. But now, we want to calculate the electric potential difference between two parts, A here and C here. We want to calculate the electric potential difference, delta V, which is equal to VC minus VA. From definition, it's also equal to the integral of A, the integral from A to B of E dot dr. Okay. But now, what should the next step is the same, that we have to choose. We have to choose the part for this integration. Now let's say that if I draw a line that perpendicular to the electric field, and then I draw a line parallel to the electric field, and we say that as in previous example, this point is a point B. Okay, this point is a point B, and A and B are separated by the distance D. Okay. To do this integration, as I mentioned earlier, that we can use any part from A to C. You may use the direct part from A to C, or any part, but in this case, we will use this part. That is, the part is from A to B, and then from A from B to C. So, to do this, I will write this as the minus of the integral from A to B of E dr, plus integral from B to C of E dot dr. You may wonder why I have to choose this part that looks quite complicated, why not go in the straight line. You can do that also, but I will explain why you can use this part. You can see that if I choose this part for our integration, and we can divide the integration into two parts. The first part on this part, and the second part is on this part. For the first part, you can see that the vector dr, on the first part, you can see that the vector dr is parallel to E. So it means that E dot dr in this case equal to E dr. Okay? But on the second part, you can see that the vector dr point in this direction, and the vector dr perpendicular to E. So it means that in this part, E dot dr is equal to 0, right? Because it's perpendicular to each other. So when we do the dot product, it's equal to 0. it means that in this part, E dr is equal to 0. And we sum up 0, which we should have the result equal to 0. Okay? So we have to calculate already on this part. And we already have the solution. So this E goes to the minus ED, which we can write down it as a okay, minus ED like this. Okay. Now, if I write the total displacement between A and C, it means that if I add up all of this dr like this, I will have the total displacement vector. Okay, which I call this vector r. You can see that the result is equal to the E dot r minus of E dot r. Okay, which is correct. You can see that E dot r is a E dot r is equal to the E r cos theta, where the angle theta is here, right? But r cos theta is equal to D, right? If you look at this figure, r cos theta is equal to D. So we have this equal to E D, which is the correct result. Okay, so we have the result of the electric potential energy between point C and point A. You can see that this point C is arbitrary in the sense that if I choose point C, or I move the point C to be here, I will get the same result because the integration on the perpendicular part will be equal to 0. If I choose C here, the result is equal. Okay, because on this part, the integral is always equal to 0 on the part that perpendicular to the electric field. So it means that at any point on this surface, okay, you have to see this in the t dimension, because okay, we write down this two dimension on the board, but it means that if you extend into three dimension on any point on this surface or plane, the result of the potential difference is the same because the integration on the perpendicular part will always zero. Okay, for example, if I draw this, if I have the plane like this, and B is on the plane, and I have A here, and if I want the, if I put C here, when you choose the path, you can choose the path like this. Okay? And in this case, also the electric field in this point in this direction. So this path is parallel to the electric field. So the integration of this path will always the same. And when you go from B to C, like this, you can see that if we look at the electric field here, and this plane is perpendicular to the electric field, if this plane is perpendicular to the electric field, we must have that the angle between the electric field and the path from B to C are perpendicular. the electric field and the path from B to C here are perpendicular. So it means that when you do the integration on this path, it will become zero. So the result of the integration are always the same. It's not depend on the point C. As long as C is on the plane that perpendicular to the electric field, we call this plane the liquid potential surface. Liquid potential surface, because on this surface or on this plane, this is a planar surface. Okay, and if you want to calculate the potential difference between A and any point on the plane that perpendicular to E, it will equal to E dot R minus of E dot R, where R is a vector that points from A to C. Right? Okay. So we call it an equipotential. Equipotential means the potential difference on any point on this plane between any point on this plane and A are equal. So we call it an equipotential surface. So you can see that the potential difference between any point on this plane and A will depend only on the distance from A to that plane, which is D. Okay? This is D. It depends on the electric field and D only. So it means that if you construct a different plane, like if I look at this plane, at any point on this plane, the potential energy, the electric potential difference between any point on this plane and A will equal, but depend on the distance. In this case, D is the distance only. Okay, so we will have the infinitely many equipotential surface, and the electric potential on each surface relative to the point A is depend on the distance between the plane and A. Okay. The shape of the equipotential surface depend on the direction or the orientation or the orientation or the direction of E. In this case, we have the parallel E, and we have the plane that perpendicular to the electric field E. Okay, you will see later that if we have a different orientation or different direction of E, the shape of the equipotential surface will change. It depends on the orientation of E.